Carson, did you know that there were 3 different school records that were broken during this last fall sports season?
Really? I had no clue.
Yeah. Both the boys and girls cross-country teams broke the previous school records for the fastest team times.
Wow, that's pretty amazing.
Yeah, and our own Gus Wanica also broke the school record for the fastest individual 5K time.
Congratulations, Gus. That's awesome. Now for more on the team's success, we'll head out and speak to head coach Matt Norton.
My name is Matthew Norton, and this is my 7th year coaching track and cross country as the head coach. I'm also an English teacher. This year is like many years in the sense that I've got a great group of kids to work with who are a lot of fun and who care a lot about being successful. I think it is unique in the sense that we had both boys and girls teams who were legitimately aiming for a state championship.
I am Karina Ernst. I run cross country and track. It is ridiculous. I definitely think as a freshman, running in the state meet would be really scary. I mean, Caleb Symington did really well with dealing with that. I think Megan and Casey, they did really well with stepping up as freshmen and being in our top 5 finishers. That's a big deal for them to be able to perform at that intensity, because there's literally like thousands of people there. And the home stretch, actually, I have to say, once you're in the race, it's the best feeling, the home stretch, just because even though you feel like crap, you are running and there's just like lines of people that are just screaming.
There are your girls 4A 2011 state champions. Let's hear for Thompson Valley. That was an incredibly amazing team effort. Nice job, ladies.
Congratulations to both of the cross-country teams for their many accomplishments this year. And a special shout-out to Karina Ernst, Haley Berg, Lauren Anderson, Casey Kaufman, Megan Irvine, Hannah Gregory, and Natalie Howard for their state championship.
Yeah, nice job, guys.
You know, another one of our school's most successful sports teams is the ladies you can see at every football game, our cheer team.
Contrary to popular belief, the cheer team is actually one of the hardest working teams in the school, and it can be seen in the way they are able to perform at such a high level.
And now, here's a piece by Mackenzie Scaglione on the cheer team.
Eagles from Thompson Valley High School.
I'm hoping that we do really well because we've been practicing really hard and we've all been giving 110% every time, so I hope we do really good.
We're going to do fabulous. We're going to do so good. We've been working our butts off this whole season to get up to this moment, and I think that we're really going to kill it.
I'm going to give it all I have and hope that everyone else does, and just encourage everyone on the team.
I feel like everyone has really stepped up to the plate lately, and we've all brought it up and like we're ready. So I feel like everyone has been doing really well.
Game to win, to fight, to conquer. To thrive, I came to win, to survive, to prosper, to rise, to blood, to blood.
Yo, I wish today it would rain all day. Maybe that'll kinda make the pain go away. Trying to forgive you for abandoning.
dancing in May. Praying, but I think I'm still an angel away. Angel away, yeah, strange in a way. Maybe that is why I chase strangers away. They got their guns out aiming at May, but I become Neo when they aiming at May. May, May, me against them. Me against enemies, me against friends. Somehow they both seem to become one. A sea full of sharks and they all smell blood. They start coming and I start rising. Must be surprising, I'm just surmising. I win, thrive, soar, higher, 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 more fire.
To fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win, to survive, to prosper, to rise.
Nice job, ladies, and keep up the good work.
Yeah, and good luck with your state competition this weekend.
Girls basketball squared off against Montbello High School last Tuesday for the first home game of the season.
The girls team came out strong and established their dominance early. They jumped out to an impressive double-digit lead by the end of the first quarter, and they never looked back.
They had great performances from starters Cassie Bulkey, Lauren Mickelson, Lauren Davis, Lexi Schoonover, and our own Skylar Marshall.
Coach Walker was very pleased with his team's performance and was happy that he was able to give some of the less experienced players more playing time.
The Lady Eagles ended the game with a 67-18 victory to improve to 2-0 on the season.
Congratulations on the big win, and good luck with the rest of your season.
Our wrestling team started their season off with a bang as they faced off against rival Berthoud on Monday night.
They dominated Berthoud across the board, receiving many pins, including pins from Cameron McCrimmon, Jacob Veranda, Cody Anderson, Tanner Williams, and Josh McLaughlin, among others.
It was a great way to start the season. Head coach DJ Jurgensen was content with an opening season win.
Jurgensen is impressed with the strength of his team this year and understands the team's chances to bring home not only the regional title, but also the state title. Hey Carson, you play basketball, right?
Yes, actually I do.
Didn't you guys have a game earlier this week?
Yeah, we actually had a game on Wednesday night against Berthoud.
Oh yeah, how'd that go?
It was pretty good. We won the game 80-64. We started off slow, but eventually in the third quarter, the team started to pull away. It was a well-rounded game for us and got us moving in the right direction. We also have a game tonight in Berthoud at the Berthoud Tournament against Northridge. It should be a great game to watch. Tip-off is at 5 o'clock as we look to improve to 3-0.
Good luck, Carson. Thanks. Well, that's it for us at the Sports Desk.
Bye.